In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. My dear brothers and sisters, I welcome you to another new day. And today we'll be reflecting on the theme, A Call to Conversion. Today we see how Lent progresses on the intensity of the call to conversion to which our Lord Jesus Christ calls us. The figure of the apostle and evangelist Matthew is very representative of those of us who come to think that because of our histories, because of our stories, or because of our personal sins or complicated situation, it is difficult for our Lord Jesus Christ to notice us and to call us in order to collaborate with Him. Well, Jesus Christ, to remove all doubts, puts the tax collector Levi as the first evangelist, to whom He simply says, "Follow me." With this, Christ does the exact opposite of what a prudent mindset might consider politically correct. Levi, on the other hand, came from a world where he suffered rejection of all his compatriots, since he was considered the collaborator of the Romans. He's also considered a fraudster because he's a tax collector. He is the one who collected tax, who imposed the tax at his own whims and put them in his pocket. But when Levi heard the invitation of Christ, "Follow me," he got up and immediately, leaving everything behind, and followed Christ. Getting up implies leaving everything you are doing, giving priority to whoever calls you, resigning to Him. You cannot sit at the tax table and follow Jesus at the same time. You cannot sit in your home and follow Christ at the same time. You cannot sit where you are and follow Christ at the same time. Follow implies changing place, moving. This is the problem that at times prevents us from advancing in the life of faith. We are afraid to get up and abandon our securities. The prophet Isaiah explained it very well in the first reading when he says, "When you banish oppressions, threatening gestures and slanders, when you break your bread with the hungry and satisfy the stomach of the destitute, your light will shine in the darkness. Your darkness will become known." Those who consider themselves prophets could not even imagine that Jesus Christ called Levi to follow Him. Not only did He call him to follow Him, He sat and ate with him at the same table. My brothers and sisters, when we are able to advance in following Christ because we overcome the immobility that stagnates us in one place, our heart rejoices, our heart celebrates. Jesus' banquet with Levi expresses the joy of the encounter. Jesus is eager to sit at our own table. He's eager to eat with us. He's eager to stay in our house. It is necessary to be very attentive to God's call and be willing to get up and leave what we have in hand and open the door for our Lord, the one who comes to bring much peace and joy to our life. May this Saturday be an auspicious day for it, and may the Virgin Mary intercede for us so that we can set out on our way, following Christ, leaving everything behind.